I am sure that you've had the experience where you've gone to a movie and you've been able to say, oh, the book was so much better. How many movies are based on books? Nearly all of them nowadays. So we're going to give you a little sneak peek here at the book table of movies that are coming up for 2014 and the books that we have that the movies are all based on. So excuse me, there's kind of a long list, so I may read some of these off, but the one I have in my hand that I'm very excited for personally, Maleficent, is the new movie that's coming out, I believe in May, and it is based on the Sleeping Snow, which princess is it? It is Sleeping Beauty. Sleeping Beauty. And she's the evil queen in Sleeping Beauty. And this one is a fun one because it is taking on, it's a live character. So it's not a cartoon-based movie, but it's based on the story of Maleficent, which I find is very interesting that they sometimes will take the backstories because they don't always cover a lot of the backstories of kind of how these villains got to be how they are and what makes them the way they are. So get your kids, and this again is a great way to encourage your kids or your if you're an adult to read a little bit before they go see the film. So Maleficent is one that I want to recommend, again, based on the movie Snow White. Sleeping Beauty. Oh my goodness, too many princesses. Some other ones I want to recommend to you is the Lego movie came out recently. Now, not only is it a great opportunity to get your kids just out and playing with Legos, but there are tons of books on Legos. Lego stories. We have books here that have Legos with them and a little how-to guide with a story that goes with them. So again, take this opportunity. Go see the movie. It's a great movie for adults and for kids. I would highly recommend the show. And then bring them in here, or if not before, get them excited for the movie by letting them read and letting them touch and see and feel and do the activity themselves. Now, down here, I have a full display of a lot of the movies that are coming out. So, Lost Survivor is coming out this summer. I haven't personally read this book, but it has been on the top 100 for a long time. And again, any of these books, in order to be made into a movie, have to have some great success stories with them. Atlas Shrugged is coming out this summer as one of their big blockbuster movies. This one, I am personally excited. If you can't tell, I have kids. But How to Train Your Dragon 2. And this one has a ton of promotional behind it. They are coming out with huge toy lines. They're re-releasing books. They're putting new covers on them. But this is a really great series. I would recommend this series from anyone from maybe third grade up to like seventh grade even. They have, they're easy to read but really engaging for the kids. So How to Train Your Dragon. The Hobbit series continues. I believe we're in the third, possibly, I think it's the third in the series. Comes out this fall in the Hobbit series. And again, this is for a little bit more of the adults or the upper teenager kids. Then we have the Mockingjay series, Mockingjay Volume 1. They're doing the movie in a two-part, possibly a three-part segment. But it comes out in November over Thanksgiving Day. But all of these, I recommend get in here and read the books before any of the movies start. A couple other ones I want to mention. One of my personal favorites is a movie that's coming out March 21st. It's a book, this one right here. It's a Divergent series. And there's three in the series now, and they're planning, they have all three movies now lined up. They're going to do all three of them. This one, I would recommend this personally for maybe a 16-year-old and up, this series, but this is a really, really, really good series. Very comparable to a lot like Legends or Catching Fire, Hunger Games type series, kind of around the same demographics as those books. But very excited to see the movie, but I've read the book first, so I know a little bit of the inside story. This one, we're very excited here at the book table because this is a local author. Utah. He's out of Salt Lake, and it's not very often that they get picked up for a major movie, but The Maze Runner has been picked up, and I think it's late spring, early summer that The Maze Runner hits movie theaters. And be supportive of this. They've only got it licensed to do the first movie. There are three books in the series, so we want to root him on so that we can get all three books made into a movie. But a couple of other books that I want to mention. Pompeii is coming out this summer. Again, a great book. Captain America is coming out. They're continuing in the Avengers series. All of these have books, comic books. There's Spider-Man's The Legend of Oz. This is the story, a little bit of the backstory of Alice. And let's see, it's never too early to get prepared for Star Wars, December 2015. Come in here and get all your Star Wars. Again, we have them from beginner early readers to clear up to the adult readers of Star Wars. Alexander the Great and Terrible, Horrible, No Good, Bad Day. I may have said that a little bit wrong, but that's about the title of the book. They're putting that to a really cute children's movie this summer that's going to come out. I'm excited to see that one. RoboCop is coming out. Planet of the Apes is another one that they're re-releasing this year. Night at the Museum, number 3, is coming out, and there are actually books on that, too. And this one's one of my favorite. Annie is going to be released this year, and they're also bringing back a lot of the old characters to play different parts in the movie, so that will be a fun one to see. But come, get these books. Let your children read them. So much better. The books are so much better. I highly recommend them. Then go see the movie. You can enjoy it afterwards. But some things you can look forward to in 2014, and stop here at the book table to get all of these wonderful books.